Hello, good morning everyone. Patricio Stivanano again here. Today I'm going to talk about copywriting. Copywriting is a very important element in business. In fact, that is the thing that your customers or your target market will see. And the first impression will lead to the next impression. And if you are successful in captivating their attention in the first place at the very beginning, then you will lead them to your products or to your services, okay? And then you will, hopefully you will close the deal with them. They will buy your product or they will use your service. Okay, let's dive to my slides. So this is a topic for today, the copywriting. It is presented in infographic so that hopefully it will be clearer as well as more interesting to you. So let's start with the definition of copywriting. Copywriting simply defined as writing with a practical purpose. The copywriter aims to inform the reader, to persuade them to change their view, or encourage them to take action. Now, this is important. This is what really matters in copywriting. You'll eventually have to persuade your readers or your target market to change their view about your product, toward your product or service, and finally to encourage them to take action. What here? Well, copywriters provide the content for advertisements. So they will deal with material of advertisement, broadcast and print, slogans and taglines, websites, brochures, leaflets, direct mail, marketing emails, articles, user guides, video scripts, and many more. So there are quite a lot of tasks that a copywriter has to do. Because copywriters deal in ideas, they are best involved early on. So if you have a company, one of the persons or one of the positions that you have to hire is a copywriter. They have to be involved early on because that's the way you will introduce them to your basic values, to your the features of your products or your service. They can identify the concepts, themes, topics, phases that form the foundation of a project. See, you have to involve them early on since the beginning because that way they will be able to know your values, your basic features. However, a copywriter can also add a lot of value by taking a fresh look at content that has already been created. Okay, fine. If you're in the middle of your business has been going on for some time, you can also hire a copywriter in order to look at your product, to look at your content, and to suggest improvement, of course. how, who, when, where, I think you can read it yourself. Now, here are the elements of copywriting. This is very important. So you have three main elements here. Let's start with the aim. In the aim, we have to think about this question. What do we want to achieve with this copy? That's the aim. And then we have to consider the audience, the people that we are going to write to, the people that we are going to address. Who will read the copy? What are their likes, priorities, worries, and dreams? So somehow you have to delve into these aspects, these human aspects, their feelings, their likes, their dislikes. What situation will they be in when they read the copy? So you take into account when they read your content, when they read your copy, when they read your taglines, in what situation are they? Somehow you'll have to consider these two. And then if you combine that, you will have this element, the desired customer reaction. So it comes down to this question, what do we want people to do, think, or feel when they read the copy? Okay, and then comes the features here. Now you have to know your product. What does the product or service do? What does your product or your service do? How does it work? What is new? What is different? Or what is unique about it? So you have to know the features of your product or your service. Yeah. And then again, you go to the audience, to the element of this element. And then in the intersection, when you combine the two aspects here, you have the benefits here, the benefits. In the benefits, you consider how do the features relate to the audience needs and desires? How will the product or service help them? You know, somehow you have to think about this. You'll have to take this into account. You'll have to consider this. Yeah. And then comes features and aim. In features and aim, when you combine them, you come to this intersection, yeah, to this shaded area. Then you define your strategy or you determine your strategy. How are you going to present the features in order to achieve your aim? So you have the features of your products here. How are you going to present it so that you can attain your aim? Yeah. Which features or benefits are most important? Again, you have to think about what are the features which you think are most important for your customers. And then if you match that with the aim, then you can define your strategy. The strategy of letting people know or of informing people the most beneficial feature in your product. Yeah. Okay, so if you have given this enough thought, then you come to the copy. Yeah, the copy is the final product of your copywriting, and that has taken into account many different elements here, plus the intersections that they share. Yeah. And as a result, you'll have a copywriting, you'll have a product of copywriting which is effective for the target audience because it has considered the audience aspect, the aim, the features of your product. Yeah. Okay, now let's move on. Slogans. Now, slogans is quite important. When I was working at Ubaya Language Center, I created a slogan. It's very simple. It goes like this. ULC. You see, it's easy. You see, it's easy. Yeah. But that very simple slogan actually hides or actually manifests the potential of the language center at Ubaya, which I headed. Yeah. It connotes the impression, or it implies, or it suggests the impression that language learning, foreign language learning, is easy. And at Ubaya Language Center, they will feel that language learning is not difficult. It's, you see, it's easy. Yeah. So it really implies something deep, despite a very simple sentence like that. Yeah. Okay, so here we talk about the slogans. You can focus on the concrete benefit. The concrete benefit, usually it is direct and forceful. It generates strong interest from motivated or interested readers. Yeah. The example is a slogan for battery. It reads, "No other battery looks like it or lasts like it." This is Duracell battery. That's the slogan. Yeah. That's really a direct suggestion, a direct statement that no other battery is as good as Duracell. Yeah. And then you can also emphasize on the personal benefit. It expresses a concrete benefit, but relates it to the reader. It combines reason and emotion. And it is used for many business to customers headlines. Okay, so for example, the iPod, you know, the iPod from Apple, one of the most prominent products from Apple, used to have this slogan, 1,000 songs in your pocket. Yeah, so this is a personal benefit, of course. It highlights the benefits that customers can enjoy when they have the iPod. They will have 1,000 songs in their pocket. Yeah. And then you have intangible benefit. In intangible benefit, there's no specific concrete benefits expressed, but it states the brand value and invites the reader to associate themselves with it. So actually, this might not be as explicit as the previous two, but they actually allude to the value, to the deep value, to the underlying value of the product. Yeah. So for example, we have Nike, and the very powerful slogan is "Just do it." Yeah. So it really suggests something quick, something not hesitant. Yeah. Right to the action. Yeah. Those are the values that Nike upholds. Yeah. Okay. So those are some considerations. Also, you can have literal question like this. Question is actually a very effective trigger for your customers. Yeah. Does your memory let you down? Yeah. Or a rhetorical question. Who knows the secret of the black magic box? Or even an accusatory question. Would you be more careful if it was you that got pregnant? So this might run in a public service advertisement, yeah, about pregnancy. Yeah. So you can play with the questions. Yeah. Also with you can also play with these elements or with these tools. Yeah. You can command them, you can instruct them to do something. For example, don't leave home without it. This is from American Express, the credit card. Yeah. Or you can issue implicit command. What will you send from a post office? This is an advertisement or a copywriting for a post office. And then you can also deliver a promise. For example, Hyundai has this slogan, always there for you. Yeah, this is a promise actually. Okay, so you can play with different linguistic forms in order to convey the most effective messages, the messages in your copywriting that will impact your readers, that will get them to act, that will change their behavior, that will change their attitude towards your products or toward an issue. Yeah. Okay, now let's go on. Yeah, you have some other elements here, mainly linguistics, so that suits you as a students of language department. The next one is how to grab their interest. No interest, no readers. Here are three main ways of cultivating interest. Benefits are by far the most powerful. News and curiosity may grab interest, but only benefits will sustain it. So I suggest that you go from here. You make your customers or you make your audience curious. They will ask, what is this all about? So you put up an advertisement, it looks quite strange, and people will say, what is this all about? Now it's a way of triggering their curiosity. They will want to know more. They are curious when they see your unique or even your strange advertisement. Yeah. And then one step from that, you have news. You will make them say, oh, I've never seen that before. It's something new. Yeah. If you produce some news, some information about your new product or your new service, they will say to themselves, oh, I've never seen that before. That looks different. Now that's here. You make them want to know more because they have read the news. And finally, you progress to offering the benefits or making them feel the benefits. They will say, that's just what I need. After knowing their product, after knowing your product and your service, they will say to themselves, okay, this is what I need. Yeah, this is just what I need. I want one of those, and that is closer to closing a deal with them. That is a step closer or a further step toward knowing your product and even buying the product from you or using the service from you. Yeah. Okay, so you can go from triggering their curiosity and then making them want to know more and then actually want to feel the benefit. Yeah. Okay, so yeah, we are going to skip this, but you can also read this on your own. I'm not going to explain it into detail. Now you have to turn your features into benefits. Copywriting gives you the chance to turn your product features or the features of your service into the benefits that the customers will enjoy. Yeah. So all features of a product or service must be turned outwards, turned toward the customers and expressed as benefits. Using the word you is an excellent way to make a benefit feel directly relevant to the reader. Yeah, this is what is called synthetic personalization. It's a way of making the customers feel like you are talking to them directly. If you use the word you, they will feel that they are being addressed directly and they will feel happy because that makes them feel special. Yeah. So use the word you in your many different kinds of promotion. Yeah. Let's say, for example, the brand or the product is L'Oreal. Yeah. L'Oreal. The feature is it improves appearance of the hair. So the benefit is, of course, people will feel attractive if they use L'Oreal. Yeah. And you can produce suitable copywriting here because you are worth it. Because you are worth it. It implies that because they look beautiful with L'Oreal product, and that's why they are worth it. Yeah. Another product is a food, Kellogg's Rice Krispies. The feature is that it makes noise when milk added. Yeah. And the benefit is kids will have fun eating them. Kids will love them. And so the suitable copy is Snap, Crackle, Pop. Yeah. So this is a play of the sounds when kids open packets of Kellogg's Rice Krispies and eat them with milk. Yeah. Okay. The next one is a newspaper. This Independent, the Independent. Yeah. The feature is that it is politically neutral. It's not biased against one party or one side. Yeah. It doesn't gravitate toward a special political aspiration. It is neutral. And the benefit is that readers are seen or are perceived as discerning and intelligent. Yeah, so people who read Independent are usually discerning and intelligent. You know, discerning means they have the ability to see things clearly. They are not easily swayed or influenced by bias. By negative bias or negative news or even false news. Yeah. And then you can produce a suitable copy for this. It reads, it is independent. Yeah. It is neutral. Are you? Yeah. Again, a question is about a very powerful means of influencing your readers, of getting them to change their attitude. Yeah, they will question their own attitude and then they will reflect on themselves and finally they will change their attitude if your copy works effectively. Interflora, I guess this is a company or a firm that produces flowers. You get flowers delivered, that's the feature. And the benefit is that, of course, the sending of flowers, of the delivery of flowers will delight loved ones. And so, the copy that you can produce that goes with this is say it with flowers. Yeah, say it with flowers. Isn't that nice? Yeah. Okay, so these are the way you turn features into benefits in your copywriting. Okay, next. Yeah, you can persuade the reader even more. Yeah, you have four principles of persuasion. You can select the ones that will work best in context. Yeah. For example, authority. People usually obey authority. They will obey or they will believe whatever the experts are saying about something. So for example, kindness is good for you. For example, a mayor or a school principal or a rector says this, kindness is good for you. Yeah, because they are a figure of authority, people will tend to believe what they say and they will also consume kindness. Yeah. Social proof is people usually follow the trend. People follow the herd. Yeah. It's like people are usually like herd. Yeah. It's like a cattle. Whenever one goes to that direction, everybody or every animal goes to that direction too. They just follow the herd. Yeah. You just follow the mass. And then it's also a tendency of us human beings. We always follow the trend. You always follow where the public goes. Yeah. So for example, 8 out of 10 owners said their cats preferred it. This is from Kite Cat, a food product for cats. Yeah. And this is actually a very nice and a very effective way of making people follow the public, follow the trend. They would say that if other people have been doing that, or if other people have been using that, why don't I? Yeah. I will follow the trend too, because if many people use that, if many people have been using that, that means the product is good. Yeah. So that's social proof. Consistency is people tend to act on their commitments. And then this translates into a copy like this. Like X, you will love Y. For example, you like apple, you will love an apple juice that we produce. Yeah. You like tea, you will love bubble tea, yeah? Things like that. So consistency, because people tend to be consistent, and you can gain the advantage of this. You can make the best use of this trait in order to get them to consider your product, your service seriously. Yeah. Scarcity, people want what they cannot have. So the more scarce something is, the more people want it. Yeah. Because probably they will see that if I can get something that is very rare, that is even more prestigious. Yeah. So for example, you can say something like, quite frankly, the American Express star is not for everyone. This will get them to think, oh, I have to have the American Express star. Because that's very rare, that's scarce. Yeah. I want to be one of the exclusive people. I want to be special. That's why I want to earn or I want to use the American Express card. Yeah, that makes them feel special. Yeah. So you can also employ this scarcity. You can gain advantage from the scarcity element. You make them think that those products are scarce, are rare, and therefore by doing that, you will trigger them, you will trigger their desire to own it, to use it, or to have it. Yeah. The more scarce something is, the more valuable it is in the eyes of the people. Yeah. Okay, here you have the most persuasive words. Okay, you can have a look at this later. Now, this comes the structure. How are you going to present your copywriting? You can present them with problem solution. So you present something as a problem, and then you offer the solution, and the solution is using your products or using your service. Yeah. So you can describe the problem that the reader faces, then position the product as a solution to it. See, Okay, story. Now, this is a very increasingly popular means of introducing a product. You create a story. So you can tell a story of how someone uses the product, how they arrived at the point they needed, how the product was developed, etc. You can put a story on your website or your on other YouTube channel, for example. A story about a dramatic story, a story that touches everybody's heart about how people go from not knowing your product or not knowing your service to actually benefiting from your product or your service. Yeah. Or the story of you struggling to get the business up and running, and after long struggle, you actually succeed in running the business, in getting the business up and running. Yeah, that's also a dramatic story that will touch your reader's emotion. Yeah, you can also have a question and answer. So you take questions from your customers and then you answer them, and other people will read them or will know them, and they will know that your product is reliable. Because every time people ask something about it, you can come up with answers which will solve the problem. Yeah. Okay, so yes, you have different structures here, but again, the first three that I explained are very important, and you can learn how to structure your copywriting so that they effectively influence the readers or influence your target market. Yeah. Okay, I think that's about it. Yeah, you have here some other means of producing copywriting, but yeah, of course you can also publish them on your web pages. Yeah, and so that's it. Copywriting. I hope I have given you the essentials of how to produce a good copywriting. Remember that a good copywriting gives the very good first impression, which will lead to your target market to know your product better, and actually eventually they will buy from you and they will use your service. Okay, hopefully it is useful. Stay safe and stay healthy. Goodbye. See you again in my next episode.